Mr. Larch, you have heard the case for the prosecution. Is there anything you wish to say before I pass sentence?
Well, I'd just like to say, my lad, I've got a family, a wife and 6 kids, and I hope very much you don't have to take away my freedom. Because, my lord, freedom is a state much prized within the realm of civilized society. It is a bond wherewith the savage man may charm the outward hatchments of his soul and soothe the troubled breast into a magnitude of quiet. It is most precious as a blessed bar, the saviour of princes, the harbinger of happiness, yea, the very stuff and pith of all we hold most dear. What frees the prisoner in his lonely cell, chained within the bondage of rude walls, far from the owl of thieves? What fires and stirs the woodcock in his springe, or wakes the drowsy apricot betide? What goddess doth the storm-tossed mariner offer most tempestuous prayers to? Freedom! Freedom! Freedom!
It's only a bloody parking offence.
I'm sorry, I'm late, Bernard. I couldn't find a kosher car park. Don't bother to recap, Bernard. I'll pick it up as we go along. Call Mrs. Fiona Lewis.
Call Mrs. Fiona Lewis.
I swear to tell the truth, the whole truth, and nothing but the truth. So anyway, I said to her, they can't afford that and what he earns. I mean, for a start, the feathers get up your nose. I ask you, 4 and 6 a pound and him with a wooden leg. I don't know how she puts up with it after all the trouble she's had with her you-know-what. Anyway, it was a white wedding, much to everyone's surprise. Of course, they bought everything on the hire purchase. I think they ought to send them back where they come from. I mean, you've got to be cruel to be kind. So Mrs. Harris said so. She said, the dead crab. She said, well, her sister's gone to Rhodesia, what with her womb and all, and her youngest as thin as a filing cabinet, and the goldfish, they've got whooping cough, they keep spitting water at the Brabbies. Well, they do, don't they? I mean, you can't, can you? I mean, they're not even married or anything, they're not even divorced. And he's in the KGB, if you ask me, says he's a tree surgeon, but I don't like the sound of his liver. All that squeaking and banging every night till the small hours. I said, well, his mother's been much better since she had her head off. Yes, yeah. I said, don't you talk to me about that. Don't you talk to me about that, as I said.
Mr. Bartlett, I fail to see the relevance of your last witness.
My next witness will explain that if the lordship will allow. I call the late Arthur Aldridge.
Late Arthur Aldridge?
Yes, my lord.
Mr. Bartlett, do you think there's any relevance in questioning the deceased?
I beg your pardon, my lord?
Well, I mean, your witness is dead.
Yes, my lord. Virtually, my lord.
He's not completely dead.
No, he's not completely dead, my lord, no. But he's not at all well.
But if he's not dead, what's he doing in a coffin?
It's purely precaution, my lord, if I may continue. Mr. Aldridge, are you where you are, a stockbroker of 10 Savona Close, Wimbledon? Mr. Aldridge!
What was that knock?
It means yes, blood. One knock for yes and 2 knocks for no. If I may continue. Mr. Aldridge, would it be fair to say that you are not at all well? In fact, Mr. Aldridge, not to put too fine a point on it, would you be prepared to say that you are, as it were, what is generally known as, in a manner of speaking, dead? Mr. Aldridge, I put it to you that you were dead. Uh-huh.
Where is all this leading us?
That will become apparent in one moment, my lad. Mr. Aldridge, are you considering the question, or are you just dead? I think I'd better take a look, my lad. No further questions, blood.
No further questions. You can't just dump a dead body in my court and say no further questions. I demand an explanation.
There are no easy answers in this case, blood.
I think you haven't got the slightest idea what this case is about.
Blood, the strange, damnable, almost diabolic threads of this extraordinary tangled web of intrigue will shortly, my lad, reveal a plot so fiendish, so infernal, so heinous.
Mr. Bartlett, your client has already pleaded guilty to the parking offence.
Parking offence? Schmarking offence, my lad. We must leave no stone unturned. Call Cardinal Richelieu.
Oh, you're just trying to string this case out. Cardinal Richelieu?
A character witness, my lad.
Hello, everyone. It's wonderful to be here, you know. I just love your country. London is so beautiful at this time of year.
You are Cardinal Armand Duplessis de Richelieu, First Minister of Louis XIII?
Oui.
Cardinal, would it be fair to say that you not only built up the centralized monarchy in France, but also perpetuated the religious schism in Europe?
That's what they say.
And did you persecute the Huguenots?
Oui.
And did you take even sterner measures against the great Catholic nobles who made common cause with foreign foes in defense of their feudal independence?
I sure did that thing.
Cardinal, are you acquainted with the defendant, Harold Larch?
Since I was, so I.
Speaking as a cardinal of the Roman Catholic Church, as First Minister of Louis XIII, and as one of the architects of the modern world already, would you say that Harold Larch was a man of good character?
Listen, Harry is a very wonderful human being.
Well, in view of the impeccable nature of this character witness, may I plead for clemency?
It's only 30 shillings.
Not so fast.
Why not?
None of your smart answers. You think you're so clever. Well, I'm dim.
Dim?
Dim!
Consternation! Uproar!
Yes. And I've a few questions I'd like to ask Cardinal so-called Richelieu.
Bonjour, Monsieur Dim.
So-called Cardinal, I put it to you that you died in December 1642.
That is correct.
Aha! He fell for my little trap.
Curse you, Inspector Dim. You are too clever for us naughty people.
And furthermore, I suggest that you are none other than Ron Higgins, professional Cardinal Richelieu impersonator.
It's a fair cop.
My life, you're clever, Dim. He'd certainly taken me in.
It's all in a day's work.
Oh, with a brilliant mind like yours, Dim, you could be something other than a policeman.
Yes.
What?
If I were not in the CID, something else I'd like to be. If I were not in the CID, a window cleaner me. With a rub-a-dub-dub and a scrub-a-dub-dub and a rub-a-dub all day long. With a rub-a-dub-dub and a scrub-a-dub-dub, I'd sing this merry song. If I were not in the CID, something else I'd like to be. If I were not in the CID, a window cleaner me. With a rub-a-dub-dub and a scrub-a-dub-dub and a rub-a-dub all day long. With a rub-a-dub-dub and a rub-a-dub-dub, I'd sing this merry song. Hey!
If I were not before the bar, something else I'd like to be. If I were not a barrister, an engine driver me. With a chuff-chuff-chuff and a chuff-chuff-chuff.
Mm.